Hey everyone, in this video I wanted to talk about an AI feature that I think is going to be more and more popular in 2025, and that is taking AI art to the next level by having it make a vector from the beginning of it. So as you know, if you're creating AI art, one of the downsides of it is most of the time it's created at a smaller size, 1024 by 1024, and you either have to upscale it, which a lot of apps do, or you have to vectorize with some do. But what Creative Fabrica is doing is that it's just creating the vector file right at the get-go from the prompt. So you don't have to vectorize it after the fact. It's already making it a vector. So I think shortening that window, making it a lot faster, is going to be something that we're going to see in 2025. I'm going to show you how Creative Fabrica is doing it right now, and you can do it right now if you have Creative Fabrica, and I'm going to show you the results of what it does. So I'm going to take it into Affinity Designer, show you how easy it is to scale up and remove the background and all of those things, because it is a vector and SVG file. So let's get into Creative Fabrica, and I'm going to show you where to find this and how to do this. All right, so here we are in Creative Fabrica. Make sure you've signed in. If you have Creative Fabrica, the way to find it is it's in Flow, which is part of Studio. So look, just go here into Studio, and I believe this right here also takes you to Studio. So let's do this one first. And oh, this is just kind of a link to tell you what is Studio. I'm not in Studio yet. Let me hit Start Designing. Yes, great. Okay, so you get to this page, you can see Studio is the graphic design app, where kind of like Canva, where you bring things in, you can add text and things like that. But Flow is create anything you want with AI, and I'm going to show you that right now. I have a video for Studio if you want to learn that. I'll put that up here so you can learn how to do Studio, but we're going to do Flow, and they all kind of work together, but I'm just going to show you Flow right here. Now, Flow is their AI part of it, where you can come in and type a prompt and do different things. And here's what's different. So you can choose the type. They've always had full render, transparent patterns, and now SVG. So you can go straight into the prompt and it will create, if you choose this one, SVG. And I'll show you what the SVG is. It's a vector file. You can bring it into Affinity Designer, Illustrator, whatever, and remove the background, change the colors, scale everything up, move points around, whatever. Now, the next thing you're gonna wanna choose is the style here. Magic style, photoreal, 3D style, low poly. I'm gonna do three or four different styles so you can see the difference. I think my favorite is cartoon, so I'm gonna do that one first. So we have, make sure you have SVG here and cartoon, and I'm just gonna do the same prompt for all of these. I'm gonna say a cute dog wearing a Santa's hat and a red and white striped scarf, and that's it. And you can use some of these things right here of a fox wearing a Santa hat, cat wearing a top hat, or whatever. So it kind of gives you some suggestions. You can also bring in, if you have art that you've already done or art from here that you've seen anywhere, you can just drag it in as a reference and it will try and use that as a reference to copy. But we're not going to do any reference. You can see I did a cat here with a black cat that I did earlier, but this time I'm going to do a dog. Okay, so square. Oh, make sure you do the right size. I think 3-4 is good, but also 1-1 would be good for t-shirts. Some of these other ones would be good for other things. I think 9-16 is kind of too tall. 3-4 is probably great. Might be a little tall. That's why I'm going with square, but either one of those two would work for a t-shirt. And then again, SVG and cartoon, and this is just to hit go. Oh, and I could make this private right here so nobody sees it on here, but it's fine. I don't care if people see it. If you want to, you can. So I'm gonna click here, and you can see it's doing four at a time, and it's gonna show you right here that you chose SVG, cartoon, and square. And I can cancel this if I want. I can give it a thumbs up or thumbs down if I find something that I don't like. Okay, let's wait to see what happens. Yeah, cool, right? So some of it, sometimes it doesn't give you a good one, but I like this one right here. And I like this one. Maybe this one's not so great because the ball should be over here. So, but three out of the four looks really good to me. So I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this one. I'm gonna show you that you can take this and open it up in Affinity Designer. I'm gonna heart this so you can do that. And I can download it here. I can also use it as a reference. I can add it to a design in Studio if I wanted to do that. I can generate this again, or I can add this to the next flow. So if I click on this, add it here, and then I can use this as a reference if I want something else. But before we do that, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try and choose SVG again, but then with Kawaii. So you can see here, SVG, Kawaii, same prompt. Let's see the difference. So I wanna show you like three or four to see, show you the which one you might wanna use. I do like cartoon the best, but we're gonna try this one right here and go. All right. It's gonna take a little while, but I'll come back to show you what it looks like. All right, so you can see this is SVG and Kawaii, and the eyes are a little bit different. The shape of the face is a little rounder, like you would expect for Kawaii. So just a little bit more Kawaii, more cute is what Kawaii is for. So let's do another one. I'm gonna try low poly. Make sure we're on SVG still. Okay, so SVG, low poly. I wanna show you this, what this does. And it's kind of a cool idea. It's kind of, well, you'll see. So low poly means it's kind of more digital. You can see the straightness of it kind of comes in like that. So less vectors, I guess, is one way to say it, low poly. Because you can see it's not as smooth. It's a little bit more angular here, low poly. So kind of fun. This is a fun way to do it. I like this one right here. I'm going to hit a like on that one. Okay, let's just do one more, and I like this ink blot one. Make sure we're on SVG again, and we're gonna hit this, and let's see what happens. All right, so here's a SVG ink blot. You can see I like this one right here, kind of a, more of a sketch, and then we can see how to use some of these. So I'm gonna download this one for the ink blot. I'm gonna download this one for the low poly. You can see it's downloading to my downloads folder. Which one of these? I kind of like this one. Okay, we're gonna do that one. And then this last one, I think I liked, let me move my face. Was it that one or this one? Wow, they're all, the cartoon one, my favorite, is pretty good. So I'm gonna do this one and download that right there. Okay, so next step is I'm gonna bring these into Affinity Designer. We're gonna see what size they are, first of all. I'm gonna open up a artboard in Affinity Designer 4500 by 5400, bring it in, and I'll show you what you can do with these SVGs. They're totally vector. You can scale them up, change the color, remove the background, all of it, because that's what it is. It's a SVG and it's vector. All right, so I wanna show you how it downloaded, first of all, so you can see it's a .svg. These are the four that I just did. I'm gonna drag them into Affinity Designer first, not into this artboard. I'm gonna drag it into the actual app. They're gonna open up, and then I'm gonna copy and paste it into this artboard. All right, so here's how each individual one opened up in Affinity Designer. You can see they're all SVGs. The way you can tell is looking at right here on the layers, like, look at all this. Every single one of these can be moved or colored if I want to color it or whatever, right? So I'm gonna change that back. What you want to do is you want to select all, or you can remove the background. I'm gonna hit Command A, select all, copy, and I'm gonna go back to my original artboard right here, and I'm gonna go do Command V. Now you can see it is small, but the thing is with a vector, you can click on this, group it, and then just stretch this thing as big as you want, and it doesn't matter because it's a vector. It's gonna look the exact same way. It's not gonna pixelate. You can see when I go in, it's this color is a solid color. It's still really good. So I'm gonna do four of these. I'm gonna do my artboard. I'm holding down Option Shift, and then I'm gonna remove this one here and just bring in the other one. So that's what you wanna do, is come in here. Let's do this one. Remember, Command A, and then Command C to copy, come in here, click the artboard, Command V right there. That's the size. Let's see the other one here, select all, Command A, Command C, and Command V here. You can see that. And last one here, select all, Command C, Command V on this last one. All right, so let's make him the right size first of all. So if you wanted a t-shirt, now holding down shift will make sure that it scales proportionally. If you're not holding down shift, you can kind of make it all wonky like this. So hold down shift if you want to keep the proportions the same. Same thing with this one, shift and drag. And this one, shift and drag. All right, so first off, let's say we want it on a black t-shirt. So I'm gonna do the background black here. You can see that kind of worked. If I did the background black here, you can see this still has the white. I can come in here, knock out that background, and look what happened is some of that was white. So because it's a vector, I can come in here and I'll have to come in and kind of draw my white back in the parts that I want white. So I'll have to do that later. Let's see what happens here when I take away this white and see if any of the white moves. No, that, well, this ball right here. And that's real easy fix. So because it's a vector, I can come in here and let's see, just kind of draw like this, like a random shape. Make sure that that's white. And then put that in the back, boom, easy like that. And if we want to make everything white, maybe we don't want this shadow here. Remember, this is a color, so I can come in here and pick this color and make it white if I wanted to, right? So there you go. And then if this isn't pure white, yeah, it has a magenta and a yellow, make that pure white too if I wanted to. So you can see I can easily change like the colors of the eyes if I wanted to make this lighter. Let's say that they had this kind of eyes instead, right? I could do that. So real easy if I want these cheeks to be a different color, maybe I want them pink or something like that. I can do that, right? Because it is a vector, I can change anything. Okay. This one's gonna be interesting. So if we move to black on this one, I'm gonna guess that, everything's that color. So I'm gonna have to come in here and color it with white. Now one fast way you could do that is with the pencil tool here, and I can just kind of trace over it really quickly, you know, and come in here, boop, 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 and if I wanted that, and then make that white and put it in the back. So you got a lot of flexibility here. When it's a vector, so you can change things like maybe you don't want this to be white here, you wanted that to be red, you can come in here and take the same color here, you know what I'm saying, and this can be the white thing again too. So come in here with your pencil tool, whoops, and kind of do this, come around, boom, put it in the back. Isn't that cool? So I did really fast, but you would want to come in here and make that better. So look how cool that is though, that's a vector. I can come in here, all of these are vectors that I can change and add stuff to or take things away. If I don't want this on there, I can take that away, or I can change the color of it. Isn't that cool? And obviously I would have to fix that, but this one too. I think this one needed just a little circle right here. Let's do that. Send that to the back. Boom. All right. So yeah, you can see how powerful this is. I don't need to upscale it and wait for the thing to upscale. I don't need to press a button to vectorize it. It's already a vector. So I think this will get even better and better as we get AI improves, but this is amazing. It kind of just takes that one step that you needed to do from upscaling or vectorizing, and it just does it in that step. So I think this is the future of AI. Of course, AI art is gonna look better and better, but and I think the vectorizing tool is gonna get better and better. It's probably gonna get a lot smoother and things like that. And maybe the layer structure will be even better, so you know where each color is and stuff like that. That's what I'm hopeful for. But it's really cool to see this, because what's nice about it is you can lay over your text here, you can change the color, you can, you know, it doesn't have a background. Like, you don't have to worry about trying to get those little details of removing the background. It's already done. So hopefully you have fun with this. I think it's just gonna keep getting better and better, and I'm glad that Creative Fabrica has it. So there you go. That was AI art straight to vector using Creative Fabrica and Flow. Let me know what you think in the comments. Have you used it before? Have you used AI art before? What do you think of this new feature? I think it's really cool. In my opinion, I think it kind of saves you a step, like I've been saying. So I know this is just going to get better and better and be able to use it a lot better for print on demand. At least I think more and more AI we'll see in the future, crossing fingers that more AI art is going to go this way, because it knows, at least for print on demand, it knows that we need to delete the background and scale it and all of those things. And just having it a vector makes it a lot better. So thanks again for watching. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you. And if you want to see that studio video that I talked about, this one right here with Creative Fabrica, where you can actually build your design using Studio within Creative Fabrica, watch that one right there. Thanks again. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.